Hey, Zeke here at Faria. New Supra is finally out. Whether you love it or hate it, we're pretty excited to start working on the cylinder head. This B58 engine coming out of this car. Well, overall, we've found some great things already with the valves. Looking at first, the exhaust valve. So we analyze every particular component that we're going to manufacture to improve one, the longevity, as well as the durability throughout any type of engine that we typically look at. So first off, we're going to look over the valves. Exhaust valves that come out of this OEM engine are sodium filled. This is not a great thing for a race type engine, higher boost levels. I'm talking 1,000 plus horsepower engine. The sodium filled valves will not last on these type of engine platforms. So how do sodium filled valves typically work inside of an engine? Well, the engine typically, when it generates 200 degrees Fahrenheit, the sodium that's put inside the stem area as well as the lower portion or the radius portion of the valve, it gets filled up about 60% of sodium inside of that stem area. Once you hit 200 degrees on your engine, the sodium then liquefies and now it travels up and down the stem area of the valve. This is great for heat dissipation, especially for OEM engines. Why? Because the engine's very governed, has a certain camshaft lift, a certain boost, a certain ECU, certain program data, everything. Compression, everything is governed specifically to work with these type of valves. When you go above 1600 degrees Fahrenheit, now the sodium inside of that stem area starts boiling, and then it can start evaporating most of that sodium inside there. Well, the travel area will no longer start working. That's very dangerous because at that point, you have a very small 6mm valve with a hollow area. That can be catastrophic to an engine at that point because now you have a material that's not really appropriate to work in a hollow stem type environment overall. That's the exhaust side. Now, what we found on the intake side is completely solid. And it's a 5mm stem. This is a great, great intake valve for very, very light weight throughout, and as well as looking at the design, it's really, really well done throughout. Now, we obviously look at improving one, materials, processes, as well as looking at then the design to build something so it sustains 1,000, 1,500, 2,000 horsepower throughout. So first, let's take a look and see the differences on the valves, how much weight we actually gained when we actually made a solid exhaust valve comparable to the sodium OEM exhaust valve. How much weight did we gain there? And then how much weight did we gain or lose on the intake valves compared to the R valves and then compared to the OEM intake valve? So let's look over the total weight on these valves and see how much we actually gained and lost overall. So first we did a comparison to see between the intake and exhaust valve how much weight in total are both these valves. So the OEM valves came out at 66.8 grams. Our valves came in at 69.8 grams. Now, let's do a comparison on one intake valve compared to the OEM intake valve and then a comparison of the Faria intake valve. So our valve came in at 30 grams and the OE valve came in at 32 grams. We lost 2 grams there on the intake valves. That's fantastic with our design and our own materials throughout. Now let's look at the exhaust valve. So the OEM valve was at 34.8 grams and our valve came in at 39.8 grams. Now that is a 5 grams difference. Again, because we're comparing our solid superalloy Competition Plus series valve compared to the sodium filled valve that comes out of the OEM engine. Initially, we looked at selecting several materials. The one material we selected right away for this type of application is listed under our Competition Plus series valves. Now, the exhaust valve is a mnemonic 90 type material, so that's our superalloy. That can sustain 2400 degrees sustained temperature onto the valve. Now, the intake valves we selected also under our Competition Plus series is our special alloy type material. That's our VV50 stainless steel. So the next process is to actually look at the valve spring kit. So we'll take a look at the valve springs, the retainers, the locators, the locks, everything, the entire valve spring kit itself. We'll take a look at that next to improve, again, the valve train components so it can sustain this higher horsepower and the environments that we typically look at. I want to thank Titan Motorsports for sharing that content with us. Don't go away. You'll see the ETA mile an hour this car did. Thanks for watching, guys. Till next time.